There's a strength to the men of Camelot. There's an undying loyalty to the throne, to the king, to the realm.
These guys are hardened knights, they're warriors. We learn what Arthur's capable of and who he is. We learn to love him and support him and give him our all.
Circle the king! Protect the king!
Kay is Arthur's older brother and protector. He's always there, you know, keeping things in check and keeping an eye on him.
Stronger together.
He knows that these guys have seen battle. They've seen war. A lot happens as he comes into his friendships with them, and particularly Leontes.
Nobody threatens the king, neither in training nor in jest.
When you meet Gawain, you realize that he doesn't really have any interest in joining any band of knights. But when he gets to Camelot, I think he realizes that Arthur is somebody worth investing his skills in.
Now this is a king I can do business with.
What's beautiful about the men of Camelot right now is they're really trying to create something.
The men have a sensitive side. They're kind of in touch with their female center, which is, it's interesting. It's not black and white.
Merlin's told us what's possible. What can be built here with you?
Every single one of the knights has their own opinions and has their own ideas of what justice should be and how the country should be run.
These rules are all the time governed by morality and by duty and by the sense of right and wrong.
A council of champions. I like it.
Honor, duty, knighthood really is what drives these characters through this world.
A lot of the dynamics in the show are reflected in our dynamics on set.
Actually, we're living like knights, bizarrely enough. Holding swords every day, being manly.
We do have that camaraderie. We do have that energy on set. And then they call rolling and we just put that into the scene.
This is turning into a good night.